Hey guys, welcome to this video. Today I'm gonna do an installation of PopOS 19.10 on my Cister 76 laptop. PopOS is based on Ubuntu, and Ubuntu came out with the 19.10 versions. So PopOS also came out with their new version of their operating system. PopOS is made by System76. System76 is a producer of very nice, very good computers and laptops specifically designed for Linux. So if you ever want to buy a good working Linux hardware, like a laptop in all kinds of sizes and that kind of stuff, or an PC, go to System76. There are very beautiful machines, and yeah, combined with this operating system, everything works flawlessly. So what I did now is I started from a new USB disk. You know how to create a new USB disk, or else I will show it in a later video, or link it on top. This is PopOS. Let me go to Firefox. I connected it to the Wi-Fi here. So Wi-Fi is working, sound is working, as you can hear. I check those kind of things. I will go to System76 website. So here you can see what they are creating. So laptops, very beautiful laptops, all kinds of laptops. So the Galaxy Pro, the Darter Pro, Gazelle, and Oryx Pro at this moment. So currently I'm running on the Darter Pro. So this is my machine. Oh, they have more even. So the Adder they now have, and the Several. So they're very gaming, more gaming-like machines with 17-inch screens and that kind of stuff. So very good. But they also have the desktops. So you have the Telio. That's a very beautiful machine, very powerful machine, by the way. That kind of stuff. So they have the Mini. That's based on the, or you can see it, the Intel machine specifically for them. So very beautiful. And of course they still have servers, also specific for Linux machines. But we're having a look at PopOS. PopOS is the operating system that they're running on their machines. So it's a very beautiful system. It's very beautiful looking, so design is very good. Although it's based of course on Ubuntu 19.10, they made their specific things work the way they want to, and also with the driver updates and firmware updates and that kind of stuff, they do it in their way. Also they don't use any snaps, so if you install the system, you will, if you install software, you will install it from the repositories directly and not via snaps. So that's, I think that's one of the advantages. By default they offer you encryption, so if you have a laptop and you take it with you, encryption is very advised. Yeah, TensorMan if you use it, because yeah, it's a simple installation and you can use it directly on this on the systems where you install PopOS. So very beautiful system, and a very good operating system. So if you go to the downloads, you have two options. There's also something that others don't even offer you, but you have the Intel AMD and you have the NVIDIA. So if you have an NVIDIA GPU in your system, choose the NVIDIA and you download it there. And there's a complete instructions how to install. you don't see it everywhere. So here are all the steps that you can take. So on this website, very good help and that kind of stuff. Yeah, let me just go upstairs. So Pop! OS is what we're going to install. They have some pretty good releases now. And what in Pop! OS 19.10, they have the, of course, the GNOME 3.34, so with everything that they can offer you on that system. And they have specific things that they did in the operating system itself. So you have now a simple choice for a dark mode that's very well handled. It's almost instant. I'm already running it on my main machine and it runs very beautiful. So I downloaded it. I burned it on a USB disk with, of course, Belina Etcher. And now we're going ahead and install it on the system. So I will choose my language as English. Look at this very nice implementation of the installer, by the way. Very specific for them. They modified it to their look and feel. It's very good. So English, yeah, the language that I'm going to use, English. My keyboard layout is English US, yes it is, but with the specific on the Euro on the 5. Oh no, not this one of course, so this is the default. This is the laptop that came from the US, so it has the US keyboard layout. We're going to do a clean install, but this only offers you to do to let them do all the things automatically. I want to do it custom. Why? Because I don't want to use my complete disk, because I want to use this disk for later use. So I'm going to modify the partitions. So the first one is the EFI system, that's good, but I'm going to resize this partition. I will make it a bit smaller, so I'm going for 200 megabytes. That's not what I wanted. 200, I said. No. That's good. Resize. Let me just use the thing here. I want it around 200 megabytes. So this is good for me. Resize. So we have unallocated. I want to create a new one, and that will be my data partition. So how much space will I like for my data partition? Around 100 or 90, so I have something like 200 left for a second operating system. Yes. Primary partition, yes. Extension 4, that's fine. Partition name will be home and label home. So add that one, and this one will be unused at this moment. So we're going to have the UFI partition, the extension 4 for the operating system, and this will be the one that I'm going to use. So we're going to apply this. So I want to be able to install a second operating system, like another Linux system for you to watch if I want to. But my main system will be Pop! OS. And that's why I always create a separate data partition So I can keep my data separate from all my installations, and I can point out the installation to that data partition if I want to. So this is done. So we're gonna close this one. I'm gonna right click, use this partition as boot. I will format it. The second partition, use this partition because this is the 200 megabyte partition, and I will use that as root and format it as well. And use this partition. Normally I wouldn't format it because there's where my data is. This is completely new installation, so I will format it, but it will be my home directory. So here we go, erase and install. So now it's going to partition my drives and install Pop! OS on the system. So as you can see, the installation process is very simple. They also base it on, like, if you are a hardware reseller and you can install Pop! OS. On first boot, you will be asked a lot of questions about what it will be, your username and that kind of stuff. So they just install the software first, and on the second boot, you will be asked to put in all your credentials. So now it's installing the system. We wait on that, and when it's done, I will restart the system, and after that, we'll be back. Hi guys, so we installed the operating system now, so let's go through it. If you click on the right corner, you will see this menu. So here you have your sound settings, your Wi-Fi connection, you can change that, of course, your Bluetooth, your battery, so they have very nice power settings for that. 776, if it's really their system, then you have very balanced power settings, very good. And your account, of course. So here you have your shutdown, your suspend, your lock, and here are the settings. We'll get to that later. In the middle, you have your calendar settings with your notifications and the by default installed do not disturb button here. It's very good if you have if you're working, like for me, if I do a screen recording and I don't want any notifications popping up, I will do not disturb. If you're if you're working and you don't want to be disturbed, you can also set it to do not disturb. In the top left corner, you have the activities. If you click on the activities, you will see the activities overview with your workspaces here, so you can drag and drop applications to a specific workspace. You will see a search here in the middle, so you just type what you're searching for if you know the program. You have your quick launch bar here on the left, and here if you click here you go to all the applications, but let's go back for a minute. The activities overview, as GNOME is more keyboard driven, if you just click on the Windows key or your logo key or your super key, as it's normally called, if you click on the super key, you will go to the activities overview as well. Press escape to get out of it. So super key will go into the activities overview, and using another one you will, of escape, you will go out of it. As for the applications, if you click here, you go to show applications. So if you use the mouse, it will show you the applications that are installed by default on Pop! OS. If you press escape twice, it will go out of it, because you also have a keyboard shortcut on it. The super key plus A will also go directly to your applications. So that's a more instant way of doing stuff. If you want to search something, like you want to start a program and you know the program's name, you just hit the super key and you type your name of your file and press enter. So I have now started files. This is the default files that is installed with GNOME. You can see also see here directly the way they set it up. So the nice blue color, very crisp colors. And on the left you have your shortcuts. Of course you have your search key. You have different options on how to toggle your view. You can set the zoom version, session here. You can sort stuff and you can reload stuff. And advanced settings, of course. Do you want to add tabs or not? You can edit, copy, paste. Select all. If you show hidden files, your preferences, and keyboard shortcuts, and that kind of stuff. So let's go to the applications again. What is by default installed? We have the calculator. On Ubuntu, this is a snap. Here, it's just plain old installed calculator. Very fast. We have the calendar, we have the contacts, the files we just seen. We have Firefox. If you go to the About, we have Firefox version 70 at this moment. Very good. You have Kerry as your mail client by default installed. I do not use a mail client, but if you want to use Kerry, go ahead. You can also install Evolution or Thunderbird. Thunderbird is the most advanced one with all the integrations and that kind of stuff, so that's very good. I don't use a mail client because I use Gmail, and Gmail I will use in my browser. Then we have a complete group gathering of Office applications. You can now create groups yourself as well. So if I want to do a combination of my internet tools, I would drag Kerry to, come on, drag Kerry. To the Firefox and will create a group out of it. So it now has a group called Internet with Kerry and Firefox in it. You can rename it, of course, if you want to, but that's how you will now create groups of your applications. So let's go to the Office. What version of LibreOffice is installed? As you can see, it's very quick in starting. It's 6.3.2.2. Very nice. Then we have the Pop Shop. Pop Shop is where you can install all your software that you want to install. So they have some groups, accessories, games, and that kind of stuff. They have some topics, of course. You can install Steam for your gaming if you want to. Your virtual machine manager if you want to use virtual machines, or if you want to use virtual of Oracle, you can choose that as well. I'm getting used to the virtual machine manager because it's native to Linux and it works very nice. But here you have your groups. You can also see what's installed on your system. You can choose here. Let's say if I want to uninstall my Kerry because I don't use Kerry, I will look for Kerry, and here you have the option to uninstall. It's very simple. You put in your password and it will uninstall the program. So Pop Shop, very nice. It's a very beautiful system. And if you see from audio, let's go to audio, and you get all your groups of audio applications and that kind of stuff. Very nicely installed, very beautiful, very good working, by the way. Better one than the default GNOME software. You have your settings, we'll go to that in a bit. You have your system. So here in your system, you have your default things. So let's go to the disk again to see what we did. We had the EFI partition, we have our root partition, and we have our home partition, and of course the vSpace here. So that's what we did. What else do we have? We have the system monitor here. Here you can see the resources. Keep in mind, I'm now using Simple Screen Recorder to record the screen. So we're using 1.9 gig of memory. Because of that, I did take a screenshot of after my clean install. I did use a top, and after clean install, you're using just 634 megabytes of memory. So that's very nice. Then we'll have the terminal. It's the GNOME terminal. We have the text editor, that's gedit. Very beautiful, simple text editor. But very good one. Then on the utilities, you have all your default utilities, so your archive manager, your zipper, your character map, document scanner, your font settings, your the videos, USB flasher, your screenshot tool, and that kind of stuff. And we have the weather that you can set, of course. So yeah, these are the default applications installed. So like promised, we're going to the settings. So here you have all your settings. So here's the Wi-Fi settings, your Bluetooth settings, so it connects to all your Bluetooth devices, your appearance. So by here are the nice wallpapers by default installed. We'll maximize it to make it a bit more overview. They have a very nice selection, of course also specific for them. So here the default ones of Pop OS, but also a couple of nice sceneries. And as I'm going to switch to a dark theme, here you have, if you click on one of the pictures, you get this option to set it as background, set it as lock screen, or you can set it as both. I will do it as both, and it will switch to that wallpaper. But here's the new implementation of their appearance. So they're using a new engine here. Nowadays, all themes will be developed for this new engine. They're using it already, and it's instant. If I click on here on the dark, puff, instant. If I go to files, it's already changed. If I go to Firefox, it's already changed. They have a dark theme directly installed. So this is very quick and implementing very nicely. We have the notifications, of course. We have your search. Where do you want to search? How do you want to search? Your region and language settings, universal access, your online accounts, so your Google accounts, your Exchange accounts, but also they have the enterprise login as well here. So if you are using this machine in an office environment, you can log it, use it to log into your LDAP environment or Active Directory environment. Your privacy settings, so system log, do you want to purge your trash your temporary files? If I click on this one, empty the trash, purge your temporary files, when, how many times, in 30 days, so it's quite simple, by default, very nice. Your applications, how do you want your applications to behave? Sharing, this is the machine name, the screen sharing, your media sharing, that kind of stuff. Sound settings again. Your power settings, so here you want to change the things. You can set your black screen, how you will ever want to use it. Automatic suspend on or off. Your power button action. Power off if you press it. Network settings, so here you can see the cable is unplugged, but I'm using Wi-Fi. VPN, so you can use VPN settings here. Network proxy, if you're using a proxy. Your devices, so how do you want your devices to behave? Your refresh rates and that kind of stuff. Your resolution. nightlight. Do you want to use nightlight or not? I want to use nightlight, sunrise to sunset. I will set it a bit less here because this is very warm by default. Your keyboard shortcuts, like I said, they have very nice keyboard shortcuts by default. You launch your terminal with Super T, hide your Windows with Super T. You move your workspaces, move to the second workspace, third workspace by Super plus down or up. Yeah, very nice shortcut keys. Look at it, and you will get, once you get used to it, you don't want anything else. Do you want to use natural scrolling or not? Do you want to use edge scrolling or not? Printers, I don't have printers, are we not going there? Remove media, what do you want to do with it? Thunderbolt settings, if you have Thunderbolt ports installed on your laptop or machine. Color settings, do you want to use a laptop screen? Do you want to do it automatically or not? So here it's set automatics, very fine. And the firmware. And last but not least, the details. So here you can see the about. We're running Pop! OS 19.10. The device name is by default Pop! OS. I will change that, but for now, let's leave it. Memory, what processor are we running on? Your graphic driver, your GPU. GNOME 3.34, OS type. And the disk size, date and time. For me, it's set to Amsterdam, of course. I don't want AM, PM. I want a 24-hour clock, so you can see it instant change here. Your users, so you can add more users, remove users, and that kind of stuff. And the default applications. What do you want to use for your web browser, your calendar, your videos, music? Images and that kind of stuff. So yeah, it was a quick overview of Pop! OS. A very beautiful system. Believe me, once you get used to it, you will want to use it. Once you get used to the shortcut keys, you won't use your mouse as often as you're used to. Very nice, very beautiful. Try it, because once you tried it, you will love it. Is it a replacement for your Windows environment? Yes, you can use this on a very old system. I have installed it on my very old HP laptop and it ran very, very smoothly. So it's very good optimized operating system and will run like, yeah, whatever you can think of. Try it, use it, and if you like the video, subscribe. If you don't like to read the video, don't subscribe. Leave a comment if you want to use have some questions. Leave comments with your questions. If you have some suggestions for next videos, leave a comment. If you want me to do a video about how I would use my system, so install my software and that kind of stuff, let me know. I will do it. Yeah, for now. Let's say, have fun with Linux, and see you in the next video. Bye for now.